Let me just say, having found this out, by us at Mass, we participate in the eternal liturgy, where the divine and human mix, and that perfect mix happens in the person of Jesus Christ when he became incarnate. And so in the Mass, we enter into that eternal liturgy, and we enter into the crucifixion. He died once, and only once, for all people in all places.
So you're declaring universal,
so all people are going to be saved.
Because that once for all is in the Greek specific time. So you're saying it's once for all time. So when you do bring it back, when you call him down from heaven, you are re-crucifying the Lord of glory. So in all reality, it's a mysticism. But where you are eating a loaver, and in your mind, you have said it's Christ. Not as a remembrance of him, but you're saying it's actually him. And when it gets stuck in your tooth, proper doctrine actually says to scrape it out, put it in water, and drink it because you have Christ left in your mouth. That is heresy. I'm telling you to repent and believe in Jesus and Christ alone, and not to trust in the Roman bishop, but in the one true Christ. And right now, you are actually one who's leading people astray. Titus 1 actually tells me to warn you sharply, and here I am warning you sharply.
I appreciate that.
I love it.
I appreciate that. What's your name?
My name is Brian Richards.
Brian?
Yeah.
I'm Austin. I'm a seminarian. I appreciate it.
Austin? I'm Chuck.
Chuck?
Yeah.
Nice to meet you, Chuck.
In your catechism, Austin, chapter 13, or excuse me, paragraph 1367, it says that you're making the sacrifice of Christ in the Eucharist.
We're talking about Mass? Right.
Yes, right, in the Eucharist. And that it's in an unbloody manner.
That's right.
So you're re-crucifying Christ.
It's not re-crucifixion.
Well, it's a union with the original crucifixion of Christ.
That's what's
right? Right. And that it's an unbloody sacrifice, right?
So, again, let me just say what I said. Jesus died, we agree, once for all people in all places.
But it's for all people.
Hold on.
The catechism, let me read it to you. Let's start with it.
Let me just, can I respond to him?
Sure.
So, we talk about Jesus died and redeemed all humankind, right? And not only that, people that don't, you have to believe in Jesus to get to heaven. We good on that?
Yeah.
Okay, so when we say that, when a Catholic says that Jesus redeemed the world, he redeemed everybody, that to redeem means to buy back, right? So we, through original sin, all of humanity has been infinitely separated from God. That's why he sent his son to collapse that divide so that we can be united with him. So to redeem, Jesus brought us back to the kingdom of God, the kingdom of his Father, through his blood on the crucifixion, okay? So that's what we mean by redeem. So redeem all people, every person, no matter what your state of life is, every single person in the past, Abraham, right, because they had to be saved too, right? So by redeeming us all, we all have the choice then to follow Jesus. And so that's what we mean by redeem. Just to be clear, you know?
Okay.
I do have to get to the Pope's...
One final point.
Okay, go ahead.
Paragraph 1367
of the Catechism
says that you're celebrating Mass, an unbloody sacrifice of Christ. Right?
We enter into the same sacrifice, but it is presented again.
The sacrifice of Christ and the sacrifice of the Eucharist are one single sacrifice, quote unquote, offered in an unbloody manner.
That's right.
Right? Okay. Hebrews 9:22
okay.
Is without the shedding of blood, there is no remission of sin. Your sacrifice cannot remit sin. It cannot remove sin.
Well,
you're a false sacrifice.
Yeah.
False Christ with another Christ.
Yeah.
Leviticus 17:11,
yeah.
Right? The law, which was the type that Christ is the reality of, right? God said that the life of the flesh is in the blood, and I've given it to you upon the altar to make atonement for your souls. That's the atonement. The life of the flesh is in the blood. The blood atonement. You say you have a sacrifice that's ongoing, that is propitiatory, that removes sin, the eating and drinking of Christ Jesus. It's an unbloody sacrifice. And yet the Word of God says, the Word of God says, without the shedding of blood, there's no remission. It was a false sacrifice.
It doesn't matter. We believe that's the body and blood of Christ.
Oh, I know. But both are equally invalid because your catechism says it's unbloody.
Right.
But the Word of God says without the shedding of blood,
okay, so
there's no remission of sin.
Can I respond?
Sure.
Okay, so, again, we got to go. I'm going to make this real short and sweet. But, what was I going to say? You had a lot to say. This might seem like a cop-out, but when you look into a specific phrase, sentence of Hebrews, Leviticus, and everything.
Yeah.
We need to look at the whole context of the book, and we need to look at the context of the whole Bible,
sure,
sacred scripture, as finally revealed.
Okay.
As
the
revelation.
Old Testament, the New Testament.
Let me run with you. The entire book. The entire book is about blood sacrifice. And you have an unbloody sacrifice that can never propitiate for sin.
Okay, well,
repent.
Okay.
Confess Christ, the true Christ, who sits at the right hand of the Father, the one mediator between God and men, the man Christ Jesus, who is not called down hundreds of thousands of times a day to every Roman Catholic church.
Right, that's right.
Who sits at the right hand of the Father, ruling and reigning as the one mediator between God and men, the man Christ Jesus. Look to him in faith, or you're cursed, worshiping an idol, the idol of the wafer, the idol of the cup.
Again, if it's truly Jesus' body and blood,
hold on.
If it's truly the body and blood of Christ, we're not worshiping a wafer. And second of all, we both believe in Christ, and we both seek Christ.
You have false Christ, my friend.
I think the issue is you don't believe in transubstantiation.
Exactly.
Right.
We do.
Right.
So that's why we'll never agree.
So your Christ is in a wafer and in a cup, and you're eating and drinking justification. My Christ is in heaven, sitting at the right hand of the Father. No, it is only and always bread. It is only and always wine. It is never Christ. Christ is sitting at the right hand of the Father. He does not come down when a priest invokes him. No, I know.
That's what we're right.
I know, but it's
another thing, food for thought. So,
yeah.
The New Testament is filled with Eucharistic language. It's filled, right, all right. We both seek heaven. I hope that you and I get there and that we can lead other people there.
Okay. Only through Christ, my friend.
Okay.
He said,
okay.
I am he who lives and is dead,
sure,
and behold, I am alive forevermore. Revelation 1:18.
What's your name?
I am he who lives and died, and behold, I am alive forevermore. He doesn't come down to die again. Daily.
So what's your
name? Rome calls him down.
Chuck. That's right. Chuck, Frank. Great talking to you. We won't change each other's minds.
But God can change your mind and change your soul.
If I'm wrong.
And listen, because I love you, I got to end with this. You're very kind. I'm not as kind as you. I'm going to love you more than I'm going to be kind to you. Don't die your sins. Don't go to hell. Don't fall into hell.
I appreciate your
don't
love.
Follow the wafer to hell.
I appreciate your
don't
love.
Follow the pope to hell.
I appreciate
that
your
is Christ.
Love.
Look to Christ.
Love.
You're
okay.
To the right hand of Christ.
I got
don't die your sins.
I got to see you. Bye. Good to see you. Chuck, bye.